Okay, so now if you want to do a tuck stitch, slip stitch, fair isle, you're going to want to do up that little swatch also with it, because that's going to make a difference when you do that. So as before, you knit your 10 rows with your main color, knit one, well, with the brothers at least, you knit one row with a contrasting color. Now I put my change knob to KC, and I move the carriage across one row so it selects the needles that are going to be tucked. Now, I don't like the end stitches to be tucked, so I'm just going to manually put that in. And this is where I am going to cut the contrast and color yarn. Put the main color yarn back in. I'm going to push in my two tuck buttons. I'm going to put my card to work. Now I am going to knit the 15 rows. Push that one needle back too far. Okay, it should still work out because it's only on the end. And then you're going to take the two contrasting color yarns, and luckily this one here is a nice one. It's supposed to be back anyways. And this one isn't, so what I've got to do is, first of all, bring that back, but then bring it forward to line up with the other markers there. Now I knit 15 more rows. As you see, I pushed that needle back too far, too. When I'm done with the 30 rows, I bring my main color out, put my carriage back to normal, and I stop my card from advancing, thread in the contrasting color, knit two rows, cut that yarn, and then go back to the main color and knit the last 10 rows. Now you could cut it here, or you could just take it off, but you could see where the blue is going to be. Now I have to make sure when I measure this that because I had that stitch wrong, it's no big deal. I mean, I'm still going to be able to measure that, but cut my yarn, take the work off. Let it rest for at least an hour, and then you're going to measure it as you did before. Now, one thing I did get wrong was on the knit leader, I had mentioned that you put it to 14.4 on the on the side over on the left here, and actually it should be 13 on the top and 4 on the bottom. So when you do the measurements, that's the second measurement for the rows is how you get that. Now probably what I should have done was single motif in the middle, although I don't think the tuck stitch does that. So now I'm going to let this rest, and then I'm going to measure it up as I did before. Okay, so for the tuck stitch, the purl side here is going to be the outside, because when you look at the other side, it doesn't really look that good, and this is what makes the design. So now, as I did that goof over here, I do know to have my zero mark right on the left of this stitch over here. And then, as I measure across, I look that I have 160. So now, going with this, 160 is on number 18, where the plain one I had on 17, I think it was. No, 16. So here, see, doing a tuck stitch is going to make it a little different. Then when I measure from top to bottom, and I want to measure here where the tuck is, so I get right on the bottom of that blue there, and then I get to the top of this blue here, it looks 9.5. So now on the knit leader, the top thing I would put to 9, and the bottom marker I would put to 5. So see a difference it makes when you're doing a pattern. Fair Isle probably won't be as bad, but you still want to do it just to see how things are going to happen. Okay, so for the tuck stitch, the purl side here is going to be the outside, because when you look at the other side, it doesn't really look that good, and this is what makes the design. So now, as I did that goof over here, I do know to have my zero mark right on the left of this stitch over here. And then, as I measure across, I look that I have 160. So now, going with this, 160 is on number 18, where the plain one I had on 17, I think it was. No, 16. So here, see, doing a tuck stitch is going to make it a little different. Then when I measure from top to bottom, and I want to measure here where the tuck is, so I get right on the bottom of that blue there, and then I get to the top of this blue here, it looks 9.5. So now on the knit leader, the top thing I would put to 9, and the bottom marker I would put to 5. So see a difference it makes when you're doing a pattern. Fair Isle probably won't be as bad, but you still want to do it just to see how things are going to happen.